Representative Kerry Condotta. Welcome to the 12th District.
Welcome to the 12th District. I am Shiloh Schauer, your guest host today, and we are having a great time here in studio with a special guest joining us from Olympia. In today's program, we're going to talk about week three in Olympia. We're approaching some key cutoff deadlines for the process. So on February 2nd, we have policy committee cutoff. On February 6th, we have fiscal committee cutoff. And then on February 14th, we have the House of Origin cutoff. So things are moving quickly in Olympia. We've got some big topics to tackle today. We're going to talk the Hearst fix that was passed. We're going to talk the capital budget that was passed, statewide tourism, and some other bills that are top of mind for our 12th District legislators. So we're going to get right to it with Representative Kerry Condotta here in just a moment.
Hi, Brent Crowder here at Town Nissan. Are you considering Nissan when you're buying a new car, truck, or SUV? You should. Nissan delivers quality, performance, and style, starting with the all-new Nissan Rogue, the best-selling car in America for 2017. And the all-new 2018 Nissan Titan Cummins-powered diesel truck with a 100,000-mile warranty bumper-to-bumper. Come down and see us at Town Nissan behind Costco in East Wenatchee.
Another good thing about this new year to buy a new car is a lot of the new cars that are coming out, the technology is so advanced.
Yeah.
We've got Honda Sensing on the majority of our vehicles now, which is huge for safety. There's, you know, Apple CarPlay and Android Auto in the majority of our cars now.
Heads-up display on the new Accord.
Yep, heads-up displays. Just the technology is huge right now, so it's a great time to get into a car and experience that new technology.
The 2017 Ski-Doo Summit Sleds. Next generation REV platform. The most powerful two-stroke engine in the industry. For the unmatched handling and power to own the next side hill, the next drop, the next ride. Ski-Doo. What matters is what's next.
How did the Leonard Evans Used Car Superstore become one of the fastest growing independent dealers in the Wenatchee Valley?
Because we sell only clean, quality inspected vehicles.
And right now, while money's a little tight from our holiday shopping, Leonard Evans Used Car Superstore says, you don't need any money. If you get here within the next few days, even if your pockets are empty, you can drive away any vehicle you choose from Leonard Evans' inventory of over 150 cars and trucks. But hurry, there's only a few days left. Leonard Evans, where the name means a great deal.
Welcome back, folks. Again, I'm Shiloh Schauer, your guest host today. Joining me live from Olympia, we have Representative Mike Steele and Representative Kerry Condotta. Gentlemen, thank you for being here.
Well, it's good to be here, Shiloh. And yes, Mike made it in too. We had kind of a late floor session today.
Yeah, hi, Shiloh. How are you?
I'm great. And just for our audience out there, we are experiencing a little bit of a delay, so that's why I'm going to sit here and smile pretty at all of you while we're waiting to get those responses back from Olympia. But we're going to keep the conversation going, and let's start off with a big topic. We had a major decision for folks, especially here in Eastern Washington. You have been negotiating for over a year on a water fix for what we call, in the inside circle, the Hearst decision. So let's start with the big topic. Let's start Hearst and then talk capital budget. On to you guys.
Well, Shiloh, I think last week was a very, very good week for the 12th District and for a lot of rural Washington. The Hearst decision was a big problem for economic development. It was a big problem for our builders and real estate folks. And we've got a solution that actually puts us, for the most part, back at the status quo, which is amazing. We just never thought we'd get back to where we were, but with some very tenacious work by our negotiators, including Representative David Taylor and Vince Buys, we got where we needed to go, a significant win for all of us in the rural areas. And I have to say that it was the House Republican Caucus that held the line all this time. The Senate actually started to come apart on us, but we held up on the House side and got a great agreement. I think Mike would agree.
Absolutely. You know, one of the things I want to do is thank the counties back in the 12th District, because one of the reasons we fared so well in this decision, in this solution, is because just after 2001, when the legislature decreed that there should be some in-stream flow planning, the majority of our counties in the 12th District went to work and did that planning. So because of that effort in 2001, the pre-Hearst solution that we arrived at really has, you know, the Hearst decision in general would have no effect on our county. So we're very fortunate to see this solution. And I definitely want to thank the counties for the work that they did to ensure that we're at the very least not impacted by anything really with Hearst.
And the fact is that we did still protect the in-stream flows, because in the original agreement we had from many years ago, that was already taken care of. And as Mike said, that the counties just did what they were supposed to do under the previous law and got the things done that needed to be done. So we're really in good shape. And I'm sure this isn't over. I'm sure there will be potentially more lawsuits and more arguments. You know, I think we've been arguing over water here all the years I've been here, and we probably will for many years after Mike and I are gone. But for right now, folks of the 12th District are in good shape, and that led to the next piece, which is also important.
Yeah, so we worked on capital budget, and we're extremely, as a member of that committee, I was so extremely happy to see that pass overwhelmingly from the House and the Senate, and the millions and millions of dollars of projects that we were secured in that budget for the 12th District can now begin. And, you know, as I said on my floor speech on the House floor, we're putting Washington back to work with that budget, and we're driving economic development in rural Washington. And I'm really excited about the way that we came together on this very bipartisan budget and created what I think is one of the best capital budgets to ever come out of the state legislature.
So out of all this, you'll see a lot of projects hitting the ground running very soon, and the water's back on, and real estate's back in gear, and economic development is going, and we just couldn't be more pleased. I think last week was maybe one of the best weeks and one of the best bipartisan solutions. And by the way, that's the amazing part. This was all agreed upon by all four corners. We were a little concerned about the governor, but he did come through and sign it. And so it was a very good bipartisan agreement for everybody and really set the tone for things, hopefully, going forward here in Olympia.
So I don't want our audiences to lose the key information that you just shared, because a lot of times in Olympia, we get used to the pace and the flow and the things that we're doing. And so back home here, our listeners that are tuning into this show today, the important thing is those folks that are in areas where they don't have water service by a domestic water system and need to drill a well, now they can go ahead with those building plans and do that because of, like you said, Mike and Carrie, the great works our counties had already done to position us. Now, I do know there'll be some reduction in the flows. We used to have a 5,000-gallon limit a day being able to extract out of those wells. I think there's some reductions for that, but because of the planning work that we've done back home, we're really going to be in good shape. We're still going to have good flows coming out of those wells. The other thing I want to touch on for folks that may be a concern, I know there's two pilot projects that are going to be doing metering, and metering of wells, there's some concerns about that. I don't know if you want to speak to that and maybe what you're going to be looking for, but bottom line, people can get back to building in rural Washington, which is a good news for us. So I just want to talk about that metering bit, though, because Carrie, sometimes is what you say is that the camel's nose is going under the tent maybe a little bit on that issue. So let's maybe dive into that quickly for our viewers here at home.
Well, thanks, Shiloh. You know, it's really important to mention, as you did, the work that our counties have done. And because of that work, even though we're seeing that reduction from 5,000 gallons per minute down to 3,000. Our counties in the 12th district won't be affected because we've limited that in-stream flow to lower amounts already. So we really won't see an impact at all from those reduction in flows. I think it's also important to, as you mentioned, the pilot programs. Those pilot programs are going to occur in counties where those programs are already happening. So they're just taking those programs that are already happening and calling them now pilot projects. So you're not going to see that necessarily expand to other areas in the state without significant conversation to follow after the completion of those pilot projects.
So as you can see, the overall agreement was very good. Now there are areas that are more affected. The places that didn't do their homework, didn't do their watershed plans, will be severely reduced and will have higher costs, and those are mostly in Western Washington. But for the most part, the folks that did their homework and did what they were supposed to do are going to be just fine, and we are very pleased with the results.
That's fantastic. We're going to have to go to a break here quickly, but I also don't want our viewers here for the 12th District to lose sight of our legislative group. Got over $68 million worth of projects happening in the 12th District. There's many great things that are going to be taking place, from helping schools develop to potentially a new emergency operations center for the 12th District, which will be fabulous, to some facilities within higher education. Our team has done a phenomenal job. I know, Mike, that you're a freshman in Olympia, but a freshman sitting on the Capitol budget, you have really helped our community. We appreciate that. Carrie, you being our senior delegate in the delegation, being on appropriations, you're doing a phenomenal job. We got that win because a lot of the hard work that you guys have done. So $68 million coming to our area because that passing of the capital budget. Thank you, gentlemen, for your hard work on our behalf. We're looking forward to getting those jobs to work here in Eastern Washington. So we're going to take a quick break. We're going to come back. We're going to talk tourism and some other important issues that you both are working on for us and maybe that you want us to be paying attention to going forward in session. So we'll be right back.
SkillSource specializes in assessing and guiding youth, adults, and laid-off workers who want to improve their skills. Here you can attend in-depth workshops to assess skills and interests, make career plans, and learn computer basics.
Learning centers provide eligible youth and adults individualized computer-assisted basic education. Vocational training is arranged with approved providers like community colleges or on the job with businesses.
Don't wait any longer. Let's get working on the future you've been dreaming about.
This is the NCW Life Community Calendar brought to you by LocalTel. Get your tickets for a night at the museum. This evening for adults will include music, drinks, tasty bites, and fun at the Wenatchee Museum and Cultural Center January 20 from 6 to 9 p.m. The last weekend for Lake Chelan Winterfest 2018 is January 19 to 21 in Manson. The weekend includes Apple Bin train rides, Ale Fest, Ice Tower lighting, live music, and more. For more information, visit ncwlife.com.
Join me each week for Life with Lisa Bradshaw. It's not about my life, it's about yours.
Is this really what we're gonna do on our girls' night out?
We should go to Club Crow.
The bar and grill in Cashmere?
Yeah, let's go.
Looking for a fun-filled, friendly hometown atmosphere? Club Crow Bar and Grill in Cashmere is the place to be. Hi, this is Justin. Here at Club Crow, we have full bar and restaurant, live music, a dance floor, pool tables, pull tabs, and live jam sessions the first Sunday of every month. Club Crow in Cashmere, the coolest place in town.
And we're back with the 12th District talking to Representative Mike Steele and Representative Carrie Condotta, coming to us live from Olympia. Thank you, gentlemen. We are going to be talking in the second segment about statewide tourism and a few other bills that they've got their eyes on, as well as that they're working on behalf of the 12th District. So let's kick it off with statewide tourism. Representative Condotta, you sponsored a bill last session that still has legs, and you're working on this session to reestablish a statewide tourism marketing program. Can you tell us a little bit more about that?
You bet. We're really excited about some developments there. It moved out of committee in the Senate. It probably won't end up being my bill because the Senate's going to have to take the lead on funding it. That was the issue. Everybody liked the bill. We refined it. We got it to a point when when everybody agreed on it, but getting funding was the problem. It looks like the Senate will fund the bill, get it started. Hopefully we can do the same in the House, and we'll have the first statewide tourism program since 2011. And frankly, then we'll be, with all the other states that do this, we're the only one that doesn't, as we've said many times. And I know that that's got to be a big boost for the 12th District, and I'm sure of all people, Mike can attest to that.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, as we're keenly aware, Shiloh, that tourism is a major, major economic driver for the 12th District. And, you know, every day that we're without a statewide messaging or marketing engine is another day that we've lost market share on the national level. And we, beyond other states, have way more to offer, in my personal opinion, than a lot of the states across the nation. And it's exciting that we're going to hopefully get a bill that will allow us to finally tell that story and to message that story in a way that's going to be impactful to the economy. And look, it's a great industry. It's really a green industry. Mm-hmm. People come, they spend their money, and they go home. And that's a great thing for the 12th District. It is a great thing for the state of Washington.
And Shiloh, I want to thank you for your efforts on this. You've been a great leader on this issue. You've worked with me and with Mike. And I think the 12th District, if we get this done, can directly take responsibility for getting the first statewide marketing program back in gear in Washington State. So good job.
Well, it's been a lot of fun to be able to work with both of you gentlemen in the Washington Tourism Alliance. I was in the Senate last week testifying on this bill. It's encouraging to see the committee taking quick action. They passed the bill out the same day that they heard it. Also, just in some follow-up conversations I had with some senators over there, it does seem that it's a bipartisan priority for the Senate. And so we are hoping that when it does come to the House, we'll continue to be able to be the leaders that the 12th District can be, understanding the importance of this industry to our state, and hopefully get a program that will tap into other rural communities so that they can experience some similar economic growth and development for tourism in rural Washington. And so as much as you want to thank me, it's awesome to get to have legislators like yourself who are passionate about these issues and are willing to go to work without necessarily needing the credit for it because it's the right thing to do. So let's continue to keep pushing this ball down the field and let's make this happen this year. Let's get that mechanism in place and get ourselves a statewide tourism program. Let's move on, though. Let's talk about some of those other bills that you guys are working on in Olympia that are also important to the 12th District and the state in general. So, Carrie, you want to start with you and tell us what you have on your watch list and that you're still working on for us back home.
Well, I think my most important bill this year, with all the money we've got, tremendous amount of cash in the bank here because of the tremendous growth in the economy in the last year particularly, we can easily roll back some of those property taxes that we put in with the education program. Now, this doesn't reduce education funding. It doesn't change the McCleary formula. What it does do is soften that blow of that initial property tax, which everybody's going to feel when you get your statements this year. We're doing our best to see if we can roll some of that back. We have the money to do it, and that's exactly what we should do. And there is an awful lot of other bills. I'll let Mike take a moment to talk about his.
Yeah, thanks, Shiloh. It is a tremendous amount of volume going through the legislature right now. We introduced more bills in the first 8 days than we saw last session, over 900 already introduced. But several bills that I'm working on really have a small business bend to them. Service animal legislation that basically helps to give some more teeth to folks that are misrepresenting those service animals inside our small businesses and really causing some problems, as well as a redirection of some B&O tax that would allow employers with 50 folks or less an opportunity to redirect their B&O tax toward continuing education for their employees. My hope is that we start to see the sort of just the innate nature of the B&O tax in general, siphon it off and start using it for all these other programs. Then why does it exist? So it's just another sort of example that we're working on there. And then, of course, I have some legislation around scholarship displacement for higher education university-level students who receive outside philanthropic donations for scholarships, and then their financial packages are reduced. So my goal is to stop that practice from happening in Washington State, making us the second state in the nation to recognize and stop that practice.
As you can see, Mike's a pretty busy guy, but that's good. Since he brought up small business, Shiloh, I got to tell you, one thing I've noticed here I'm very concerned about is that I'm seeing a lot of these really old, hardcore labor bills that were way back even when I started that are coming out of the woodwork, because now that all three corners are controlled by our opposition, so to speak, or our Democrat friends on the other hand, depending on how you look at it, they are more union-oriented again, and it's not an anti-union statement. Some of these things are okay, but a lot of it creates a stacking on small business, and the problem is right now with paid family leave, paid sick leave, highest minimum wage in the country, some of the highest payroll taxes, having all these other new bills stack on top of that, it's just a lethal cocktail for small business in the state of Washington, and I'm really concerned about some of the ones I've seen. Now, they've been defeated year after year after year, and we hope that they just are rattling the sabers again, because these would be devastating to our small businesses in the 12th District. So that we're on watch on that, too. So we're playing offense and defense, frankly.
I think that's a great comment, Carrie, talking about offense and defense. What some of our viewers at home may not quite understand in terms of the rhythm of Olympia, and another little fun fact of what happens in a special session, the entire House is up for election during a short session. And so sometimes we see these bills and it's just to get the political fodder going and the conversation going. And with such close majorities in both the Senate and the House, the next upcoming election is going to be a big battleground. And so although it is important for us to watch these bills, especially those that could continue to impact our small businesses, because that's really how our local economies are built and how our communities grow, is because of the health and the climate, the business climate of our small businesses, but also understanding that we cannot let down our defense when these bills come out, because this could be our future if we don't have balance and control within the legislative body. Having those close majorities and or backstops, be it a House or a Senate in the opposite controlling party's control, is not a bad thing in Olympia. And so thank you, gentlemen, for the work that you're doing. And I'm sure that that's part of why we're seeing some of these old bills being resurrected again.
Well, that's right. And I think it is a lot of saber rattling. Last but not least, I know we're probably getting short on time, but the one that we get a lot of inquiries about from back home is the carbon tax. That is the governor's major initiative this year. We are seeing some movement, but when you really get down and analyze it, this carbon tax, overall carbon tax, doesn't make sense in the state of Washington, which is the cleanest power producer, perhaps, in the world. We'd like to see a more targeted effort at transportation, where most of the carbon is. I've got a bill on semi-trucks to convert them to electric over a period of years, and some incentives there, and also to extend the electric car incentives, which are starting to run out. Even solar energy, there's some good things we can do there. So we'd just like to see a more targeted approach. This blanket approach would hurt a lot of our folks in the 12th District and not reduce carbon in the meantime. So I think that one's losing a little steam. What do you think, Mike?
I would agree. You know, and one of the things that I have said in several of my updates is I would like to see us develop a system in Washington State that encourages and incentivizes good environmental stewardship. You know, the way we work over here in Olympia is we find the hammer and we use it in order to get people to comply. And I don't think that's the way we create environmental stewardship that's effective and lasts in the long term. So my hope is that we would target things specifically and look at the people that are doing things well and give them incentives to expand their practices to help other areas of the state do a better job and ultimately reduce carbon emission in a real and effective way, rather than just driving up the costs on your middle to low income folks who depend on the reliability of transportation to get to and from work. And you know, you're basically hitting them in their pocketbook when you raise the gas tax 60 cents.
The best environments are consistently where the best economies are. That's true worldwide, and we don't want to damage one for the other either way. And we can have both if we just do it right. So that's what we're working on, and I think it's hopefully it's going to work out really well for us.
As usual, you guys have big issues and a little amount of time to try to figure them all out and potentially let them settle into the way to the next session and or prop them up to pass them through into this year into law. We thank you very much for your time today on the 12th District and for the great work that you're doing. We're going to take another break and then come back and close out. So thank you, gentlemen, for this update. We appreciate the work that you're doing, and we look forward to talking with you again next week.
We'll see you next week, Shiloh.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is State Representative Kerry Condotta inviting you to check out our newest show on the NCW Life channel. We call it the 12th District. Each week, we'll be taking an in-depth look at various political issues that affect our area, our state, and the world. We'll be featuring local and statewide experts on the subject matter at hand. Please join us weekly for the 12th District with yours truly, Kerry Condotta. Check your channel guide for times or go to ncwlife.com for details.
Join us for Street Talk and Other Stuff with Mike Magnotti on the NCW Life channel. This former police sergeant is plugged into not only the world of the streets, he's an actor and connoisseur of the arts. So join Mike and his guest for, well, Street Talk and Other Stuff. Mondays at 10 a.m., Tuesdays and Thursdays at 2 p.m., and Wednesdays at 5:30. It's Street Talk and Other Stuff with Mike Magnotti on the NCW Life channel.
Family means something in these parts. Family owned and operated means even more. At Rose Tractor, you're buying more than a product. You're buying years of knowledge through multiple generations. It means you can count on Rose for quality products, quality repairs, and folks who stand behind the products they sell. From your job site, to your home, to rentals and repairs, to new outdoor power equipment, Rose Tractor is growing with you throughout the years. Rose Tractor, quality brands you can trust year after year.
Meinen Zylinder überschwemmt. Flüte, ich habe mein Fugen verloren.
Keine Sorge.
Global Car Care. We speak your car's language.
Fragen schlüssen. Hey, you.
Well, I got a leaky transmission, my head gasket's shot, and I could use some new brake pads.
That dog don't hunt.
Global Car Care. We speak your car or truck's language.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for joining me today on the 12th District. This is your guest host, Shiloh Shower. What an incredible quick interview, fast and furious, the pace of Olympia that we had today with Representative Kerry Condotta and Representative Mike Steele. If you missed the interview or want to watch it again, we invite you to go to ncwlife.com and check out the 12th District on demand. You can also stream this program live from that incredible website. Next week, we are going to be in Olympia, myself included. We're going to be doing the 12th District show from Olympia and checking out what's happening in week 4 and beyond. So thank you so much for being with me today. I hope that you enjoyed this version of the 12th District as much as I did. Have a great rest of your day, and thank you again for joining me.
Bunny.
Gardening in North Central Washington is challenging, but the rewards are well worth it.
And it's fun. It's fun every day for the whole family. And it's fun with us.
Do's and don'ts and everything you need to know about gardening in our neck of the woods, green thumbs and dirty knees right here on the NCW Life channel.
I gotta tell you, I'm nervous. Selling your home, it's a big step.
Can we find the right buyer in this market?
Look at our website. When someone looks at your home, I can tell how ready they are to buy. See that number? The closer it is to 100, the closer they are to buying. So, I know who to zero in on.
So you have a secret weapon.
You mean, we have a secret weapon.
I like that. Oh, what do you think of the wallpaper?
I love that touch.